guys, I'm Rachel.
Welcome to our new series on the parables. We are so glad you're here to join us this week. In this series, we're going to learn some of the stories that Jesus told to help us understand how he wants us to live. We're going to start by singing a song about our memory verse in Matthew 13:12. It says, "To those who listen to my teaching, more understanding will be given, and they will have an abundance of knowledge." Let's sing it together. That was a great song. That song reminds us that when we listen to Jesus' teachings, we will have a better understanding of how he wants us to live. Now we're gonna watch our Bible story so we can learn more about the stories Jesus taught when he was on earth. Let's check it out.
Stories of the Bible, the lost sheep. This is Jesus.
Hey-o!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
Jesus taught everyone about God's love. All kinds of people would come to hear Jesus speak, including tax collectors and people who made bad choices. This made the Pharisees and Jewish leaders mad.
Ugh, yuck.
They didn't think that Jesus should be around these kind of people. So Jesus told them this story. If a man has 100 sheep and one of them gets lost, what will he do?
You stay here.
Won't he leave the 99 others and go to search for the one that is lost until he finds it? And when he's found it,
hey, woo-hoo!
He will joyfully carry it home. When he gets home, he will call together his friends and neighbors, saying,
"Oh, everyone, come here, come here.
Celebrate with me, because I have found my lost sheep." In the same way, there is more joy in heaven over one lost sinner who returns to God than over 99 others who haven't strayed away.
Now What a cool Bible story. That parable really helped me understand more about how Jesus wants us to live. There are a lot of ways for us to apply that same teaching to our own lives. So let's watch the modern retelling of the parable to see how we might be able to live the way that Jesus wants us to. Let's watch it.
There was once a boy who had a bag of 100 marbles. The boy cared for each one of the marbles. Now, one of the marbles got away from him. The boy left the 99 others and set out to find the one. When the boy found the marble, he was very happy. He scooped it up and carried it back to the others. And the boy had even more joy over the one lost marble that was found than over the 99 that were never lost. He was content because his entire collection of marbles was once again complete.
Wow, what a great way to help us understand how Jesus' parable applies to our lives today. Now let's check out Rewind with my friend Tyler. He is watching some trending YouTube videos and sharing his thoughts. Let's see what he has to say.
What's up guys? I'm Tyler and welcome back to my second episode of Rewind. Rewind is a show where my team scours the web looking for the most awesomest viral videos and I show them to you, my loyal viewers. Today, we will be playing a game called Tissue Issue.
Tissue Issue.
That's right. I will subject myself to the saddest videos we could find on the internet, and I'm gonna watch them without crying. In the corner, we'll have a tissue counter, and for every tissue that I grab, the counter will go up. Make sense? Let's do this thing.
Rewind.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh.
Dad, we gotta go home.
Get up. Mufasa, get up. Get up. Man.
Somebody!
Okay, wow. That video was the worst. I mean, I love this movie, I love Lion King, but why, every time I watch this, I cry. Why, Mufasa, why do you have to leave? Why did you, oh man. I'm not wasting any more tissues on this video because it's so sad. We're at 3. Let's reset the tissue counter and on to the next video. These two guys are looking for someone named Christian. Oh, Christian's a lion. He's running. Ah! Oh, wait. He's hugging them. Oh!
We're just so, so excited.
Oh.
Look how sweet they are.
Oh, wow. I love animals. This is torture. That one wasn't as bad though. Tissue counter, one tissue for that video. Not too bad. Let's keep it going. Next video. This one's a cartoon. Oh, he's new here. Oh, poor guy. Oh, they're playing with him. Oh. They got him a gift. Oh. man. Okay. I never knew a porcupine would make me cry so much. Can I stop? Can I leave now?
Can't leave. We have two more left.
Okay. Wow, fine, okay. What's our tissue count up to? Four. Four tissues on that video. I don't even know if I have any tears left. This is crazy. Okay, here we go. Two more, on to the next video. Oh no! This is the worst! Wait, help her. Oh no, she's sick. Oh no. No. No, 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 no. Oh. I can't do this anymore. I'm so sad right now.
It's all right, Tyler, just let it out, buddy. Roll the next video.
There's another one. It's a nice little kid. Oh no. Oh no. It's going down the stairs. Oh, so close. Oh, he found it. Oh, nice. You know what? To be totally honest with you, after watching all those other terribly sad videos, this one wasn't too bad. I mean, yeah, it was sad that he lost his marble at first, but it actually wasn't that sad because in the end he found it again. I lose stuff all the time. I lose my phone, my jacket, my keys, everything. And just like this kid in the video, I go back and look for it. It doesn't matter if I have an extra jacket at home, I still go back to try and find it. It was cool at the end of the video to see that that kid had a lot of other marbles in the bag, but he still went to search for his missing marble. That little marble had value for him. So how does that help us understand the parable of the lost sheep? Jesus told us that if a shepherd had 100 sheep and he lost one, he would surely leave the flock, the 100 sheep, leave them behind just to go look for that one missing sheep. Even though the shepherd had 99 other sheep, he leaves them just to go look for that one lost sheep. And when he found it, he would be thrilled and he brings it back to the flock. And to the boy, the marbles were precious and valuable and they were worth searching for. And to a shepherd, sheep are precious and valuable. They are worth finding. But here's the amazing part. To God, you are precious and valuable. You're worth searching for. Jesus explains that there is so much joy in heaven when just one sinner gives their life to Christ. God loves us and he wants each and every one of us to be a part of his family. And because of this, he intentionally seeks us out just like the shepherd looks for his lost sheep. And because Jesus died on the cross for us, we can be forgiven of our sins. When we choose to follow Jesus, we will be able to spend forever with him one day in heaven. And by choosing to follow Jesus, by asking him to forgive your sins, you can choose to be a part of his family. Jesus loves you more than you could ever imagine. If you've never asked Jesus to be the Lord of your life, if you've never invited him into your life and asked him to be your savior, you will have that opportunity today, just a minute, with your leaders. Remember, Jesus loves you so much and is ready to be a part of your life, and he wants you to belong to his family. So just like sheep and just like marbles, you are valuable and worth searching for. All right, guys, I think we are just about done here. We will catch you guys next week on another episode of Rewind. Okay, bye.
How cool is that? Tyler helped us to see that teachings behind Jesus's parables 2,000 years ago still apply to our lives today. Well, that's all for this week. And we are so glad you joined us for our series on Jesus's parables. Remember, God loves you so much. He wants you to know him and how to live for him. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.